Thank you for watching, and in this chapter, which is called SolidWorks Quick Start. So in this chapter, we are going to learn how to create our first part, first assembly, and first drawing. So I'm not going to cover all the fine details, but I just want to mention all the essential tools which you need to create your part, assembly, or drawing. So let's go and let's start. So specifically in this video, we are going to design our first part. So I'm going to go into the SolidWorks and let's start with a new SolidWorks part. So if you want to start from the part, so you can click on the novice. And now here, if you want to start with the part, assembly, or drawing, so you can just select. So as in this video, we are going to design our first part. So I'm going to select the part and then I'm going to press OK. So right now we are into the part environment. So to design a part or to start a sketch, we need two different things. We need a fundamental plane or we need a face if you want to start a sketch. So right now we don't have any part, so we don't have any face. So, but right now we have our fundamental planes, which is front plane, top plane, and right plane. So if you want to build a part, so the first thing is like you need to create a sketch. So you can start sketching from any of these parts, any of these planes. So like if you want to start from the front plane, so what you can do is like you can just click on front plane and you can see there is an option like you can go into the sketch from here. Or the second option is you can just select any plane and then you can go here into the tabs, which into the sketch, and then you can start sketching wherever you want to sketch. Okay, so let's go into the front plane and let's go into the sketch. And now, although I'm not going to cover all these commands in very detail, although in our next videos, we would cover each and every command in very detail. But right now, I just want to start. I just want to let you know how you can design quickly your first part. So suppose I want to start up with the line. So I am into the front plane. So I just turn on the line command. So what I can do is I can just click wherever from wherever I want to start my line. I can click wherever I want to bring it. Suppose I want to bring it like this. Wherever you are gonna click, because your line command is on, so what you can do is wherever you are gonna click, so the line is gonna be formatted. So at end, what you can do is you can just click on the starting point. So in this way, what you can do is you can just enclose the boundary. And as soon as you are just click the last point, to the initial point, so you can see the whole body is converted into the bluish, so it means it is a completed boundary. And then what I can do is I can just click the green check mark, and after that, like again, I can click the green check mark. So we have a whole boundary here. So what I can do is like this is the boundary, so you can make any shape, whatever the shape you want. So the next thing is like let's go into the features here, into the feature tab, and you can see there is an option which is extruded boss or base. So if I'm going to click on that, so what you can do is by using extrude boss or base, you can create a solid on your sketch. So right now we have this sketch, so what you can do is you can just bring this arrow. As you can see, this is the arrow. If you want to expand that sketch in such direction, so you can bring it here, or if you want to go inside, you can go in that direction. Or there is another thing, what you can do is like you can just select manually here whatever the value, like how high or how deep you want to go, suppose, or there are some arrows here. So what you can do is you can just increase or decrease the height. And then there are two options. The first thing is like you can just drag these arrows here, or you can just change the direction by using these arrows here, as you can see. Or if you want, you can just draw your solid into two directions. This is one direction and this is second direction, which we are going to cover in the next videos. So right now we just want to create our first solid. So I'm just going to select the value, random value, and then I can click the green check mark. Boom. So in this way, as you can see, we have our first solid here. Sorry for distraction, but if you think my videos are helpful for you, or if you are a serious SolidWorks learner, I'm gonna highly recommend you can go into the description of this video, where you can find my course link, in which I have over 10 hours of videos in which I explain each and every command in a detailed way. Thank you. And like if you want to zoom out, so what you can do is you can just scroll the middle button on your mouse, so you can just zoom in or you can zoom out. And if you want to bring your part into the center of your screen, so what you can do is you can just press F on your keyboard. So in this way, it's gonna come over the center of your screen. Okay, and the next thing is, like, as I already mentioned in the start of the video, like, if you want to start a sketch, you need two things. The first one is you need to have a fundamental plane, or the second thing is you should have a face. So right now we have a face, like this face. So what I can do is, like, I can go into the sketch, and then I can go into the circles, and I can draw some random circles here. Like, this is my first circle, this is my second circle, this is my third circle. So in this way, I can just draw my circles and then I can click green check mark. Or if you want, you can draw some other things. Let's say I want to draw a rectangle here like this, and then I'm going to click the green check mark. So the best practice is, like, whenever you are going to sketch anything, and at that time, just to have the exact measurement. So you should give dimensions, like what is the diameter, what is the radius of the circle. You need to provide all those dimensions each and every time. But right now, this is just a quick guide, and we are just gonna practice our first solid. So that's why I'm not gonna provide any dimensions here. And the next thing is, like, we already have our sketches here. So what the next thing is, I'm gonna go back into the features again, and then I can extrude these sketches as well. And then again, you can see, like, I can expand, I can increase their height, or I can decrease, as you can see. Or you can put your manual value. Let's say I want to have a 20 mm here, so let's say 30. So in this way, you can just increase, and then I'm going to click the green check mark. So look, I have our second extrude as well here, as you can see. As I already explained in the previous videos, like, if you want to rotate or if you want to change the direction, so what you can do is you can just hold the middle button onto your mouse, and then you can move the whole part up and down, or right or left. Okay, so in this way, we have our first part, first solid part here. But what if you don't like these designs? So what you can do is you can just go into the feature manager, and then you can right click on here. Suppose I want to right click on this boss and boss extrude boss. What I can do is I can just delete these boss or base. So in this way, I'm just gonna delete all these extensions which I already applied on the face of this basic solid. But my sketch is still there. So if you want to delete sketch, you can right click on that, and then you can delete your sketch as well. Or what you can do is, you already have a sketch here. So what you can do is, like, we can use this sketch, and then we can go back into the features, and then let's explain another feature, which is extrude cut. So what you can do is you can just go into the extrude cut. I can select this sketch, I can select all of these sketch, and then I'm gonna go into the features, and then I'm gonna go into the extrude cut. So in this way, like, I can, before that, I just extrude boss or base, and in this way, I'm gonna cut by using those sketches into the solid. So as you can see, so I'm gonna select, and in this way, you need to select your dimensions, like how deep you want to cut, and then I'm gonna click the green check mark. So look at that. So in this way, by using those sketches, what I did is, like, I have extruded cut inside of that solid. And that's all for today's video. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, don't forget to hit that like button and subscribe to our channel for more videos like this one. And if you are a serious SolidWorks learner, then don't forget to check the course link in the description. Thank you. Sorry for distraction, but if you think my videos are helpful for you, or if you are a serious SolidWorks learner, I'm gonna highly recommend you can go into the description of this video, where you can find my course link, in which I have over 10 hours of videos in which I explain each and every command in a detailed way. Thank you.